use the ancient Babylonian way of making soap. We do it the original way that soap was made, which is how everything should be done, the original way. First, we start with raw oils like shea butter and olive oil. And then we have our lye, which is our base. So you have an acid and a base, and then they form together to create a salt. So you'll mix them all up together when they reach about 100 degrees. And then once you start mixing it, you reach a trace. So we actually hand mix everything. We don't use any electric blenders or anything to keep the temperatures low, which has a lot more chemistry behind it, but it results in a luscious lather and a longer lasting bar. And then once we cut the bars and get them into loaves, they have to cure, which that is more saponification. So you have to let the water evaporate, crystallization, and the saponification process to finish. So we let our bars sit for about 6 months, which most companies don't do, and they cheat the process, which is why most bars don't last very long. It's a very common misconception, but done right, you should have a hard, long-lasting, luscious lather. We don't use any fragrance or parabens or any additives whatsoever, so every ingredient in the soap, if you have on a label, you can read it. So a lot of people are like, if you can't read the ingredient, don't use it, which is very true. So olive oil, shea butter, coconut oil, rice bran, and all of the good stuff. And we only use essential oils, so straight from the plants, lavender, tea tree. There's a lot of temptation to make a pretty, glittery, bright colored soap bar, but it's harmful to the skin, which needs to be well known, because you can actually get vibrant colors out of, say, turmeric or charcoal or spirulina, but you really have to experiment, and it's a lot of trial and error. So I think a lot of people, soap makers, are lazy when it comes to soap making. They don't want to give it the time to cure, which is the most valuable process. At the end of the day, I'm delivering a handmade natural soap product that's basically saving lives, because soap is the most effective antiviral, antibacterial property like on the planet. So everybody needs soap, and the customers love the soap, and to see that it's helping people with their eczema, their acne, and all this stuff, that's what I get up for, is that people are genuinely happy with the product and they love it. Yeah, they send emails, it's their forever bar of soap, they'll never use anything else, and that's what's beautiful. We've created a family. And the family does nothing but care about their health and their skin, and it's a long-lasting support. And there's crazy stories of like people have skin cancer, and then they started using our soap and it helped with that. So that's the stuff that we live for. Yeah, it's a big family. And some people have been around since I was 13, so they have stuck around for years, and I just, every single order that comes through, I'm gonna hand pack it with love. So there's a lot of soap brands out there, and a lot of them are just experimenting. They make these pretty soaps, but those pretty soaps have micas and artificial colorants and fragrance, which is terrible. And you can actually, at soap supply stores, buy artificial stuff to add to your soap. So it's very handy to get your hands on. It's easy. You don't have to wait for the bars to cure as long. And they cheat the process. And then big soap companies cheat the process because they want to make more money. So when you use chemicals, you don't have to wait for the bar to cure. You know, there's a lot of stuff you can cheat with it. All my friends and family wanted the soap because I was making like 20 bars at a time in a little thing. But I mean, the whole family's not gonna use 20 bars, that's still a lot. So I would just give them away, and everybody wanted more. So I had to keep making more because I was the only one making soap. Had an Etsy shop, and then Etsy blew up, and then we built a website. And then I just found my passion in business through that. And then you see the stories and testimonials of people, and you're like, well, I gotta keep doing this, it's helping people.